In 2012, China accounted for more than one-fifth of the world's total greenhouse gas emissions from human activities. At a domestic level, this air pollution has become a major health concern and a driver of China's climate change policies. In recent years, the Chinese government has implemented a suite of initiatives to reduce the country's greenhouse gas emissions, including several command and control and adaptation policies. But today, we're going to focus on China's National Emissions Trading Scheme, a major carbon pricing mechanism that will cover around 4 billion tonnes of CO2 when implemented in 2017. That's close to 10% of global emissions. The design of the national Chinese ETS has been informed by seven pilot schemes that the government began trialling in 2013 across a selection of cities and provinces, including Beijing, Shanghai, and Guangdong. Each pilot scheme differs in its design parameters, such as the offset limit, method of free allocation, and non-compliance penalty. These trials have provided important information to the Chinese government on how key ETS design features, such as the way allowances are auctioned, influence the carbon price, the volumes of allowances traded, and ultimately, how much abatement is undertaken. The national ETS covers China's main industrial activities from eight sectors, including paper and pulp, power, iron and steel, chemicals and cement. The threshold for compliance is universal across all sectors and is based on fuel combustion, 10,000 tonnes of coal equivalent per year. Notably, China's ETS covers just one out of seven greenhouse gases, which is carbon dioxide. However, its size is significant. At 4 billion tonnes of carbon dioxide, the scheme covers nearly 40% of the country's total emissions. China's ETS features a hybrid auction and free allocation system for distributing allowances. Like for the EU ETS, it progressively scales back free allowances to give companies and the economy time to adjust to China's emerging carbon market. Through the national cap and trade policy, the Chinese government has set a target to achieve, by 2030, a 60 to 65% reduction in carbon intensity compared to 2005. This carbon intensity refers to the amount of emissions per unit of economic output. For example, tonnes of CO2 per $1,000 of GDP. This differs from the absolute emissions cap used by most schemes, such as the EU ETS, and it has implications for the effectiveness of China's ETS, as it does not guarantee a reduction in atmospheric emissions. Experts have warned that the Chinese government will need to strongly enforce the intensity targets for the ETS to achieve its long-term emissions reduction goals. Once implemented, the Chinese ETS will cover twice the amount of emissions compared to the EU ETS and will be the largest mitigation policy globally to reduce greenhouse gases. But while China has chosen to implement a quantity-based cap-and-trade system, there are other carbon pricing options available to mitigate climate change. In our next case study, we will look at how a price-based tax system can be used to create a disincentive to emit greenhouse gases.